This is probably the first embedded application I've created and shared based on the ESP32-P4. As you can see, this is a sticky note application. In fact, there's nothing special about it. We can already easily access these Post-it series applications on Windows, Mac, and mobile. But I thought if we make this kind of app on MCU and use it, it could be a home device that can be used more easily and quickly. Another thing is that I prefer e-paper ink displays for home IoT devices because they can run on batteries for a longer time. But this time, I tried to implement an application that runs quickly on 10-inch color display. This is super cool. The hardware used here is ESP32-P4 Nano. It is made in a much smaller size than the function EB board previously released by ESPIDF. Nevertheless, all GPIOs, MIPI CSI, and DSI ports can be used as they are. I think the most important hardware component in this project is this 10-inch display. Since ESP32-P4 supports MIPI DSI display serial interface, we can use the display used on Raspberry Pi. This can update the screen faster than the existing SPI or 16-bit parallel connected display. And I think it can reduce my and your stress from the display connection and usage. I'm very satisfied with using the DSI port, and I believe it enables a higher quality projects. So this could probably be used to implement a small kiosk or coffee machine. Now let's talk about the application. This application was created using LVGL. Let's think about a basic Post-it application on your PC or mobile app, and also think about the basic features it has. In addition to the function of creating a Post-it note on the screen, it should also be possible to move the Post-it note freely. So I made it easy to drag post. You should also be able to freely resize the post-it note. Of course, being able to write content is the most basic one. As you can see, the UI is very simple. It could have been implemented without using the UI editor. When configuring a complex UI UX, you can shorten the development time by using the UI editor, but if you only need a simple UI like this, you can implement it with just code. In this first version, I focus more on the system configuration, which is very basic rather than the screen layout. So I think there is still a lot of room for adding many features to these applications, and I think we can upgrade it together through my GitHub repo. For instance, it would be nice to add a settings menu and add the function to change various background images and fonts. Lastly, one more function I want to mention is data storage. If the data written on the screen is suddenly powered off or the device is rebooted, no matter what, it will disappear. This is because all data is stored in volatile memory. ESP32 provides its own non-volatile storage called NVS. If you save each Post-it data here whenever there is an update on the screen, the data can be preserved even if it is rebooted. If you draw the screen again with the saved data, you can maintain the same state as before. For this, I configured the system to store information about the Post-it in JSON format and enable updates. Let me show you. The device has now rebooted and the data has been read from MVS to restore its previous state. This is a kind of note, so the data must be preserved. In conclusion, I think that not only does ESP32-P4 have high performance, but it also allows for more dynamic embedded application development on the screen connected via DSI. If you have any interesting project ideas, please leave them in the comments. I will try them out if possible. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.